It obviates the nail-biting anticipation we experience while watching our favorite action and horror movies, as we wonder whether or not the hero will be able to save the day. But it wouldn't exist without a great villain to make trouble. Otherwise, the most movies would just fall flat, failing to keep our interest. Every hero needs a villain, since bad guys bring out the best in our protagonists. And giving them something good and decent to fight for, with ethics thrown out the window. Movie villains provide a suspense that is vital to most plots. While we know that many of them will probably be defeated by the end of the movie, but it doesn't make them any less menacing as we watch the story unfold. And that is why we love to hate them. And starting with this guy. To say the Joker was mentally unfit would be understatement. Clouds are already creepy, and the Joker's face paint makes him look even more crazy and menacing. The Batman's evil nemesis in The Dark Knight caused a whole lot of problems in Gotham, resulting in the creation of even more villains in the city, including his transformation of good duo Harvey Dent into Two-Face. However, like all enemies of Batman, the Joker ended up being cut off to Arkham to be crazy and villainous inside the confines of a padded room. Moving on to next guy. When people can't even say your name because they are so afraid of you, you've definitely achieved some serious bad guy status. Lord Voldemort, aka the Dark Lord, led an army of evil wizards and witches called the Death Eaters to take over the magical world by force. Even after that, an evil spell on baby Harry Potter backfired on Voldemort, causing him to go into hiding, and he still soldiered on, working his way back to the top of the Wizard of Villainy. Ultimately, there were plenty of good magical beings to thwart his plans and take him down, and the most important of whom were a trio of kids enrolled at Hogwarts by the names of Harry, Ron, and Hermione. The next one. You can't blame the Magneto for being a villain, especially since he experienced some pretty harsh treatment throughout his life. Nonetheless, he definitely fits into the bad guy category. Although occasionally he collaborated with the X-Men when necessary because he was driven by the desire for mutants to dominate human race and become the most powerful species on Earth. Magneto used other mutants to do his bidding and utilized his ability to control metal to cause harm to humans and also mutants who opposed him. This is Magneto as I talked about. And moving on to the next one. This is last but not least the greatest villain we've ever seen in movie industry. It's a shame that Anakin Skywalker fell in with the wrong crowd, since he was such a promising young Jedi Knight. Teaming up with the evil Emperor was definitely a step in the wrong direction. As he joined the dark side, which eventually led him to requiring an all-black breathing suit, his black armor apparel along with the breathing apparatus made his voice sound creepy. This is Darth Vader, as we talk about. But ultimately, in the end, he was able to redeem himself by turning on the Empire to ensure the well-being of his son. Thank you for attention. I hope you next time you see the movie with Lance, you will enjoy.